So those of us who come back to the Sault, and those of us who are here, who live here, and have come back today to see you parade on the 75th anniversary, I just want to tell you that it's fabulous for us, it's reassuring for us to know that things do not change. In this world of constant change, it is fantastic to know. It's fantastic to know that this program endures. And so thank you so much for all that you do, for carrying on with the traditions of this outstanding squadron. And one thing I will say that has changed is when we were cadets, with that trade old time, it's been 35 years since I trod the boards here, which, as you know, used to be hardwood, possibly underneath whatever this is now. When the drill team that we were on did our drill, we could make those boards sing. And a lot harder for you today. You still do the boot shining and the ironing, and I love the golden boot and the silver iron. But you don't have brass. It was one thing we all had, a can of brass though, and we had to shine our brass. And the key thing was to be able to take the feathers off the wings. On that grass, that showed you could really polish. You have chosen a new name. When we were here, it was won by Royal Canadian Sault Ste. Marie Air Cadet Squadron. Oh, my cast, et cetera. Today, you are Gordon Gray, and you have chosen to memorialize a person who, through their life of commitment and dedication to their country, and that to us, those of us who are alumni, we applaud you for that choice. That is fantastic for us to see how things progress and how it goes on to make our hearts warm about that. I'd like to also now just turn my attention to you up here in the stands, the parents and the families of these fine cadets and all the alumni here who, like me, are so thankful to be here, so grateful to you, Captain Brown, for you and your committee and the hard work you put together to make this a celebration this weekend. Thank you for supporting your kids. Without you to drive them here, or bring them here, or help them to come, they couldn't do this. So to you, thank you. Ladies auxiliary. Do we still have an auxiliary, parents auxiliary?
Yeah,
sponsored. Now it's a sponsored committee. I remember the ladies auxiliary. Helga's mom was one of those ladies, and there are several of you here today who were ladies auxiliary when I was a cadet, so thank you for what you did. There is a fantastically large community support. Look at all these people down here in this front row. You've all been thanked, you've all been acknowledged, so I won't repeat what's been said already. But thank you so much for what you do. I'm sure that when you see what these young cadets have done, their drill team, their parade, the band, the Highland dancers, it must warm your heart as it does mine that all the efforts that you put into the youth of this community are bearing fruit. So thank you again. And instructors, who without the efforts, your volunteer time, the time you take to put on the uniform, to do the training, to give your time to teach these cadets, whether it's band, Highland dancing, drill, and all the activities that you saw on the stands, the static displays that they have done, without you, this program could not be. And on behalf of the Canadian Forces, which runs the program from a national level, and the area cadet advisors, the regional cadet support units, all of those people, I want to say thank you so much. Like you, I was a cadet, wandered down the hill one evening, joined cadets, had no idea what I was getting into. But for me, and I'm sure for many, and all the people who have gone through this program, it gives you a start in life. And to you, the cadets, you made a choice to come out here and to parade every week, you could have chosen many other programs. This program asks of you to give back to your community. It asks of you to shine your boots, press your uniform, get it all tickety-boo, to come out, and you may ask yourself, what am I going to do with the skill of shining my boots? Trust me, unless you join the Army or the military, you are never going to have to polish your boots like that again. But that little tiny bit of self-discipline that we ask you to do, that this program asks you to do at this juncture of your life, is a thing that will stand you in good stead as you become citizens of your community. It is community that we are all here to partake in. You wear on your shoulder, I don't know if you've noticed, if you ever even thought about it, but you have the name Sault Ste. Marie on your shoulder patch. That's not what you're used to do. That's your city. That's who you represent when you put that uniform on. This is part of your country. We in the military, we are honored to wear the word Canada on our shoulders. It signifies our service to our country. You are in service to your city, to your communities. And this is what being in cadets, beyond what it does for you personally, this is what it will do for you as a citizen of your city, your community, your country. So I acknowledge you for the choice you made, for the guys that cut your hair, the girls put it up in a bun, not so much fun, it wasn't for me. Thank you for that. Thank you for what you do, for the examples you set to your friends and to your community. So with that, I'll just say Captain Brown and Roy. Where are you, Roy?
Yeah.
It has been such a pleasure to work with you and Laura. Thank you. I cannot tell you what a privilege and an honor it is to be invited to come back here and to be the reviewing officer for this parade. It is something I will treasure for the rest of my life, and I have to thank you for that.
Thank you, Matt.
So thank you again. I've taken enough time. I look forward to seeing everybody.